from the News Channel 5 Network. This is Open Line.
Well, good evening and welcome into Open Line. I'm Chuck Long. Glad to be along with you for the next hour. Love this hour that's coming up. We're asking an attorney, one of our very favorites here, Kevin Kennedy from the Kennedy Law Firm. Now, this man has been in the law business with his Kennedy Law Firm for over 35 years, and that's 35 years of incredible experience and knowledge. So he's going to be sharing that with you in the coming hour. And as you know, if you've ever watched, I know a lot of you have, you're regular viewers of our Ask an Attorney segment when Kevin's on. When you have one of those questions, one of those legal questions, make sure you get online with us as soon as possible because we want to get to as many calls as we can during this hour. And this is your chance, of course, free of charge, to be able to get that great, profound legal advice. And the number's right there on your screen, 737-7587 is the number to get on the line with. So here we go. Kevin, welcome. It's great to
Good
see you.
Good to see you, Chuck. We love being back in the studio again, so we're rocking and rolling. It's good to be with you. We're excited about sharing tonight. So if you're thinking about some of those questions, feel free, write them down, because you may have some family members that you're asking for because sometimes they're not available. So get it, share it, teach your family, share it with your friends and your coworkers. It will make a difference in your and their lives.
And Kevin, you know, I was mentioning the 35 years of experience, 35 plus years of experience with the Kennedy Law Firm. But it's not just that the long-standing, you know, 35 years, but it's the knowledge. We often say knowledge is power.
That's what we say.
And that's where you guys get it.
Well, that's an old saying, but it is absolutely the truth. So many people ask me, so, well, Kevin, how did you know this and how did you know that? And I have a lot of young lawyers over my career trying to teach them to take them to the next level. And, you know, some of the things that never change, honesty, character, be a person of your word. And guess what? When you're not there, you're going to end up in a legal situation. So, you know, an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. Benjamin Franklin said it over 200 years ago. It's true. And we have so many obstacles in our way of life and new challenges every, and you say, I never dreamed of that. Guess what? We're in the law business. And we said, well, we never have seen that before. So if there are trends and whatnot that we see, we like to share and give you a little heads up to make preparation. You know, they say in real estate, Chuck, location, location, location. My sons are doctors. Prevention, prevention, prevention. And in the legal profession, it's preparation, preparation, preparation. Great advice on all fronts.
Well, and it's also being prepared when something happens and
yes,
knowing how to react to
yes,
it. You know, we've often said too, you know, a lot of times people think if they have some kind of altercation, whether it's a traffic altercation or yep, run-in with an officer or something, you think, oh, I just need to start
come on
everything
come on
that,
and
that
tell
I know.
The truth.
You're
yes,
asking me questions and I just, and yet actually you have to be careful about things like that.
Totally, Chuck. All these times that you and I've spent, I can see how your legal knowledge has gone up because we talk about it each and every time, but can you tell it enough? My mother used to say, get the kids in the car, and then you can't preach to them enough, you can't teach them enough, and I'm a student of that. And even in the law business, I have the most experience in the whole organization. When something comes up, you'll see me run down and ask office administrator, well, she's not a lawyer, but she's brilliant. And then my assistant, Sarah, is brilliant. And I said, what do you think? And she says, well, something's not right here. Did you consider? So we brainstorm the team effort, and the odds are in your favor. We're coming out of there.
Absolutely. You know, and there's a number of topics, too. You know, no topic off limits. I mean, call,
yep,
make sure you get that advice. Whether or not, you know, a lot of times it might just be a problem with your neighbors and you're not sure what your rights are, what you can and can't do.
Yes.
You may be having a problem with an insurance company.
Absolutely.
You know, are you the little guy? A lot of times that's a situation.
That is the truth.
And you need that situation. Yeah.
Well, and I like it. Just the peace of mind. It will worry you and you've got anxiety. Well, try to get a little advice will make you say, man, I'm so glad I talked to you. I'd heard this. Well, there, remember this, Kevin Kennedy said there's an exception to the exception to, so if we can talk privately and we hear the facts, hello, come in, we've got an answer. And if someone's trying to bully you and said this is the law, Well, guess what? You didn't know there's an exception to the hearsay rule. Everybody said, well, that's hearsay. You can't use. Oh, you don't really know everything you're talking because there's exceptions to the hearsay rule. And then all of a sudden, the ball game changed. If I was a young lawyer, I'd watch this. If I was a middle lawyer, I would watch this. And because, you know, the law is constantly changing, and we need to be informed all the time.
Absolutely. Well, let's go to our lines. And by the way, if you're just tuning in, the number on your screen is the number to call, 737-7587. For any of those legal questions that you have, maybe it's for you, maybe it's for a family member, a friend, you've been discussing things, this is a great way to brainstorm. And of course, you're doing it with the expert, Kevin Kennedy. So let's go to the lines right now. Barbara, good evening. We're glad you're watching Open Line. Do you have a question or a comment for Kevin?
Yes, I got three quick things. And they all kind of have to do with statute limitation. Is there somewhere where the average person could look to see what the statutes of limitations are for different things? And then also, specifically, I'd like to know about how it would work with closing an estate, because obviously you can only keep it open so long. You want to get the creditors taken care of and all that kind of thing. But when do they just say enough is enough and we're closing it, assuming that there isn't anything going on with it? And then finally, what is the penalty in the statute of limitations for an application that is falsified for a vital record?
Okay. Well, you're rocking and rolling tonight, and thank you for the questions. First thing, statute of limitations, it depends on what state we're in. And Tennessee, Kentucky, we're close, but they have different statute of limitations. Contracts, 6 years. Personal property, 3 years. 1 year personal injury. And Tennessee Consumer Affairs kicks in. You say, well, I've got 6 years. Well, if you're going to get treble damages, you got to bring it within a year. Oh, I didn't know that. And you know how I heard that? I heard a lawyer say, I didn't know that. Well, that's a little too late. If the Tennessee Code Annotated will have all the statute of limitations, you probably can go and look those up and find out what you're looking for. Closing an estate, though some of those estates are open, some families are going to fight forever. I've seen them open forever. Remember this, you can always file for notice to close the estate. If anybody's got any complaints, then the court can say, bring them within X amount of days. We're going to have our hearing. If there's no issues, this is my ruling. We're going to close it. Applications, go online and look whenever you have a need with the state government. Almost everything is controlled by the state government. Is it good? Is it bad? I don't really like it. The more governmental intervention, because everybody's saying, I didn't know that. You know, they say ignorance of the law is no excuse. Well, how do we know when you go to jury trials that you're not supposed to talk to anybody when you're a juror? Did they teach that in the first grade? No. Did they teach it in this? No. But yet we're held to know all this. So again, that's why you have to keep your ears open and you're all the time talking, trying to get a little advice. Some of the best medical advice I ever received was from insurance salesmen, not doctors. Fascinating. So a lawyer, you want to know why lawyers are so smart sometimes? Didn't say I was, but lawyers in general, because they deal with everybody's problems all the time. So this morning, we learned some things through the day that you didn't know, whether it's mechanics, contracting, insurance. And remember this, a creative lawyer will interpret things differently, and he'll have a plan of attack that other lawyers didn't think about. You got to discuss it.
All right. All good information. Barbara, thanks so much for starting our show off. Great three questions. We really appreciate it. We'll go right back to our lines right now. Stephen is on the line with us. Stephen, good evening. I'm glad you're watching Open Line. Do you have a question or a comment for Kevin?
The question I have is, well, my daughter works, they're going to force them to take the COVID, and if they don't take it, they claim they're going to fire them. Do they actually have the right to force you to do something? We're telling you got to sign a piece of paper saying you're not going to be responsible if anything happens to you.
Okay, Stephen. Guess what? Our phones at the law office are lit up. Everybody's asking the same question. And so, you know, my sons are doctors, and one of them's married to a doctor. And, of course, they came in at the hospital and said, mandatory, all your doctors have got to do this. It gets into gray areas. There's a lot of gray areas. There are opinions. you know, any opinion you have can be challenged, and then that's why we go to court, and they can challenge it, they can appeal it, and what they decide, my case is a little different because I'm standing on a religious conviction, is why I'm opposed to it. As a general rule, in the state of Tennessee, we're employment at will. What does that mean? That means I hire Chuck, and he can walk away any day. No reason. Well, that's just the way it is. I could let Chuck go, employment at will, and say, Chuck, we don't have any work. You've been a good guy. We're going to let it go. And for whatever reason, I don't even have to give a reason. So that's where you're dancing. And what I'm anticipating, it's going to be a rush of these problems. And we represent corporations. And you know what they're scared of? They're scared half of their people will walk. A third of your people walk. We're already having a hard time filling these positions. So what I would say to you is I would talk to a lawyer privately, find out what options we have available to us. We have all kinds of dances that are going in the law firm, and many of these are theories of the law. And so you can take that for what it's worth. Some want to be really aggressive, and some want to be moderately aggressive. I talk privately on your situation.
All right, sounds good. Stephen, thanks so much for calling in this evening. If you do have one of those legal questions or you have a legal comment, just make sure you get on the line with us. 737-7587 is the number. We're going to take a short break. Back with more questions right after this. You're watching Open Line.